In this video, I'm going to show you how to do the min-max scalar example that we just did by hand, but now in sklearn. So the min-max scalar, as always, is something that I first find out about by visiting the sklearn documentation using Google. So when I Google for an example, I get something like this, and I click on the first link. There's a number of different functions that Python has available to you for pre-processing data. We'll be looking at the min-max scalar today, and that falls under this paragraph of scaling features to a range. This is the documentation page that I had open when I came up with the example that I'm going to show you right now. So in order to make it maximally easy to follow, I would suggest that you sort of have this open in a parallel tab in your browser. But I'll also be explaining each step as I go through it to show you how to use this in a practical example. I come over to my terminal window and I fire up the Python interpreter. And the first thing that I'm going to need to do is import the module. The next thing that I actually need to do, this is one of the things that was tricky for me the first time around, is import NumPy. Because as you might have sort of noticed by now, a lot of the sklearn functions require NumPy inputs. So let me show you what I mean. I'm going to be using weights data in this example. So I'm going to create a feature called weights. And as it happens, I'm going to make this into a NumPy array. I just got this from the example on the sklearn documentation page that I showed you. This is kind of me following the steps that they laid out. What I do now is I make my input data. So in this case, I'll be using the weights example. And something that's a little bit tricky that I had to play around with to figure out is that what you actually want is a NumPy array. Each element of the NumPy array is going to be a different training point. And then each element within that training point is going to be a feature. So in this case, I'm really only interested in one feature, the weights feature, and then I have three different training points for my three different people. So when I put in my data, it looks like this. Now that I have my weights data input, I'm ready to use the scalar on that. Here's the scalar that I imported from sklearn.preprocessing. And I want to have a new feature that's named rescaled, let's call it rescaled weight. And to make rescaled weight, what I do is I call fit transform on the weights. So this actually does two things. The first thing that it does is it fits. So it does things like find the X min and the X max. And then the transform actually applies the formula to all of the elements in the set of data. So this is doing two things at the same time. Sometimes you'll only want to do one or the other. Now I've actually set myself up to make a mistake here. Let me show you what happens. All right, so we got an error here that says it's assuming floating point values as input, but instead it got integers. And the reason why has to do with this line right here. All of these inputs are integers, but it's expecting floating point numbers. And if you were looking at the documentation, the example very closely, as I was doing this, you might have figured out that this was going to be a problem down the road for us. So I'm going to turn these into floating point numbers by putting a decimal point after each one of them. And we'll try this again. Great, that looks much better. Let me print it out now. And there's our new transformed feature. So there's the 0.417 that we calculated in the last example. You can also see that the smallest value in the list has a rescaled value of 0, and the largest one has a rescaled value of 1, which if you look at the equation carefully, will immediately become apparent that that's always going to be true. So this is an example of how you can use the min-max scalar in sklearn to do, in just a couple lines, what we did by hand in the last example.